metaverse. Please stand by. This is Pacing 3.0's EDM World News. I am Pacing 3.0, the EDM and drumstep vocalist, Zombie Supreme. Today, everyone, sorry about that. Today, we're going to be talking about a couple of subjects, starting with, we pull out a little clipboard here, okay? Starting with Spotify previews NFT galleries on artist profiles. That's something. And of course, within, I gotta remember how to pronounce his name, DJed a pop-up rave at an abandoned LA zoo. This is Pacing 3.0's EDM World News. Take it away. Forgive me, folks. Forgive me. You like the song in the background? Boop! Hello there, hello. The song in the background is mine called Turn Up, Let the Music Heal You. You can hear it on my SoundCloud. And we'll get to that at the end of the show. But right now, I forgot my crown. I am the queen, the mother of the Nile. The Emperor, the Empress of EDM, the Godfather. Okay, you let my little sign here, is it on? It's not on? Hold on. Hold on. Is it on? I need it to be on. I don't know what's going on here, but is it dead already? It's supposed to be sent. You read what it says. Let me know in the comment section if you can read what this prophecy is. You probably can. It's too dark. But it's supposed to be saying, thinking, please wait. Because I'm always thinking, right? I have. I'm always thinking. I'm trying to run this business here. Anyway, by the way, for those of you who are brand new, I'm not really a YouTuber. I'm just a music artist at EDM. The music artist at EDM, vocalist on the Supreme. I have a studio to give my fans a little more of me than just the music and a little post on social media. Right? Anyway. Let's get to the story, the first story. I'm sorry. I've got to say, that's what I want to say. I got a brand new camera, a brand new iPhone. I told for the first time in life I've owned an iPhone. Yay! I got a bonus check for my job, honey, from the hotels in Las Vegas. Okay, they blessed me on social media, so you know. I ran into an incredible graphics, gaming fast computer with a fast processor. So now my graphics will be slowing down. Ain't no bad camera quality. Still gotta work on the lighting, you know, but anyway. So let's get to the first news story, okay? I'm sorry, I'm looking up over here. I'll only be looking at you. Oh, this computer is so amazing. She runs like a pearl. Anyway, so. Within DJ, oh, that's the wrong news story. We get to that in a second. So Spotify previews NFT galleries, okay, on artist profiles, and I'll read. I gotta get this thing closer, honey. I can't see that. I don't need glasses, but I sure can't see that a super away. There we go. By the way, how's your day today? Comment in the comment section. Let's have a discussion. Anyway, the world's biggest streaming service is hopping on the NFT bandwagon. Spotify is testing a feature to include NFTs on select artist profiles. Don't open the Spotify app to try it out just yet, okay? Only a sample of Android users. Okay? In the US are a part of the feature test, which is actually a flip because usually Android people, users, I've been an Android user for a long time. Comment if you're an Android user, okay? I've been an Android user for the decade that, you know, before it started to come out in 2010. I've been an Android user. Here we just went to the iPhone. Here we go. Had my reservations about iPhone even when I could buy an earlier version of the iPhone. And then I was like, I'll shoot myself in the foot. We need to get an iPhone. You know, I got the latest model. You know what I'm saying? And I went to my provider, Cricket. Shout out and comment below if you got Cricket. If you know what it is in the US, because I think it's only in the US and nowhere else. But it may have expanded. I don't know. They business. But I got an iPhone 8. It's pretty. It's my favorite color. Yes. But anyway, usually iPhone gets everything, you know, whatnot. iPhone, but I guess, I don't know, I guess Android, you know, finally gets some love. So, but too bad I'm no longer an Android user anymore. So, anyway, I don't care really about NFTs. Are you into NFTs? Give me my other video. Please go ahead and check my other video out. Okay. About DMFI's NFT. I think I got a couple of NFT videos because these DJ producers are getting on the NFT game. But anyway, I'm on the fence about NFT still. I may regret it later. I don't know. But anyway, Spotify is running a test in which it will help a small group of artists promote their existing third-party NFT offerings via their artist profile. Says the company, as reported by TechCrunch, we routinely conduct a number of tests in an effort to improve artists. I just had a little burp there. And an effort to improve artists and fan experiences, requests from industry partners, and deepening connection between artists and fans also cited as reasons for the feature. NFT galleries on artist pages are a simple grid of static images. Videos, GIFs, sounds are not featured in the Spotify app. However, direct links to each NFT OpenSea page are displayed in the app for users to fully explore and purchase an NFT. Okay. I mean, does Spotify really need that? Do they? These ads getting on my nerves. Hold on. Does Spotify really need that? I don't think they do. But anyway, because when I listen to music, the last thing I'm thinking about is an NFT. Like, what goes on here? What goes on here? Anyway, NFT galleries on artist pages are a simple grid of static images. Videos, GIFs, sounds are not featured in the Spotify app. Oh, we already read that. I'm sorry. Anyway, commissions or fees for purchase says initiate through the in-app navigation will not be applied to Spotify. Stevie Aoki and the Wombats are among the select group of artists featured in NFT preview. Given Aoki's fervor for NFTs, his participation in the test is no surprise. It's uncertain whether the NFT previews will be anything more than an experiment since Spotify mentioned to the aforementioned tech publication that such tests end up paving the way for a broader experience or serve only as an important learning. Okay? So Spotify doesn't even know if they want to actually actually begin with this. We're just kind of rolling out as a test of a few select people using Android. And I guess we'll see how it works out. But honestly, if anyone from Spotify is watching, y'all don't need that feature. Ain't nobody choose the jazz about the NFT feature on Spotify. I mean, come on. I think it's silly. Personally, maybe I'll eat my words. It would be really successful, but honestly, I think I'd put your money somewhere else. Like putting your money towards, I don't know, actually paying the artists like me who are on the platform some actual money. Thank you. Well, folks, I'm not up there right now, okay? I'm just on SoundCloud with a few songs, but I will be up there once I release my EP and album, okay? But like I said, artists struggle on Spotify. We don't want to get paid shit. Anyway, we're going to move to the next news story. Comment below. Do you feel that the NFT idea of Spotify is a good idea? Let's have a discussion. And do you... We're going to move on. I'm sorry, I'm screwing up your name if you're watching this. DJed a pop-up rave at an event in LA Zoo. A police helicopter eventually showed up, but not before Withane threw down at the Wild Show, the latest in Brownies and Lemonade's pop-up series, okay? And that's the only way to do a promotion. But not because the police called him here. Okay.
Hey there. This is the Los Angeles Police. Get your hands up. Get them up now. What are you doing here? What is this? What? Everybody's hands up. Excellent.
Okay. Basically, I guess. Lions and tigers and bears. Oh, my. And with that, recently DJed at an abandoned zoo in LA, where he threw down for a surprise pop-up show, a police helicopter eventually showed up, okay? But not before the prodigious Savage producer's untamed performance, which showcased his new sophomore album, Midnight, okay? Is Midnight out yet? If it is, I'll review it in my series, Turn of a Burnup. And if it's already out by now, let me know what you think of the album before I review it. Let me know what you think about the album. Or you even know what they think. Okay? Is it worth not listening to? Let me know. Performance was organized by Brownies and Lemonade at the old Los Angeles Zoo, which they call one of the wildest locations they've ever been in for a show. It was the latest in the esteemed producer's BNL pop-up series, following a sun-kissed DJ set by Grizz at LA's Dock Walla Beach in early April. Okay. Following a sun-kissed DJ by Grizz at LA's... Did I say that already? I'm sorry. I'm crazy. Anyway, thanks to pie in the sky sets like these, Brownies and Lemonade, who were named EDM.com's best event organizer of 2020, have emerged as one of the most beloved events in the dance music space. Okay. I mean, that's pretty darn bold. Well, I'll say that. Pretty darn bold, Withane. According to a screenshot shared by Withane, for any of you at this pop-up thing at LA Zoo, if you're in LA or you've been to LA, were you there? Let me know in the comment section what actually happened from your point of view. Anyway, according to a screenshot shared by Withane that appears to be from the Citizen mobile app, the party was eventually reported to the authority. A police helicopter arrived within 2 minutes of the incident report. Per the screenshot, and confirmed that approximately 200 to 300 people had gathered for a pop-up raid. Okay. Yes. Well, listen. I know there's a lot of artists out there on the internet, okay? A lot of artists out there trying to get their shine, trying to get their time, they trying to make it. Okay. And so sometimes, I guess the artist, you have to be very creative with how you decide to roll out your next album, right? Very creative, but maybe not as creative as with Thang, because, like I said, I don't know if the article tells me that whether they got arrested or they have to break it up, and so that's kind of where it stops. But I wouldn't try that if I was you, an artist watching this right now, or DJ. Because, like I said, you don't know what ramifications it could have, and you may not be lucky as him. He might not have been lucky. I don't know what happened to a thing. But anyway, that's all the news stories I had for today. We'll keep it short and sweet. This has been Peyton 3.0, the EDM and drumstep vocalist Zombie Supreme. I promise my lighting will be even better the next time. So I gotta get this to my life to come back in here. But anyway.
Thank you so much for coming and staying to the end. Most of you are my troopers. Most of you are my actual diehards. My Zombatrons, my Peytonators. Those are two interchangeable names for you. Okay? Now I'm going to get to the last part of this before we go today, of this episode. We're going to get to the social media. Yay! Okay? Social media.
So as you can see behind me here, we have over here, sessionslive.com, okay? And with sessionslive.com, you go ahead, that's a platform for Pandora, like a Twitch, but it's for musicians. I got graphics on there too, I sing live, you can come over and support, request your favorite song, hear me sing, all of that, rap, whatever, my originals, and have a good time, you know,
have a good time,
sorry, I'm thinking, anyway, oh yeah, when you do go there, you can press the follow button, you press follow, if you press subscribe, it's going to charge you $4.99 a month, but hey, worth it, get in the fan club, jump in the marriage right away. Oops, you didn't see that. I don't care. Anyway, jump in the marriage right away, okay? And let's make a commitment for $4.99 a month. But I understand money's tight and things like that. Would not trust me, I understand. Then just press the follow button because this is going to cause you to enter your email in, create a screen avatar, you know, whatnot, a screen name, and get ready to participate and be a part of my awesome Zombatron family. Also behind me, I have three free unreleased songs at the Bitly link. Can you see it? You can, because I'm in front of it, so I want to actually get out of the way. Okay. Yes, at the Bitly link back there. Website is peyton30.com. SoundCloud. The point is to get on my email list. For those of you to qualify, which we all of you watching this video, obviously. You're in the fam, you qualify to be on the email list and get updated and get alerts about new albums and songs and other things and merchandise, all of that stuff. Okay? SoundCloud.com/Peyton30, Instagram.com/Peyton3_star, Facebook Zombatron Community, which is Facebook.com/Peyton30. Okay? TikTok at Peyton3_0, and YouTube, which is this right here. Which, if you don't do anything else, I need you to do one more thing for me. Hit my likes. Hit my likes, please. Okay? Make sure you subscribe, you comment. This is social media. This is the community. This is not a TV station where you just turn on and watch. I know some of you are busy. I want to thank you so much for even being here and watching until the very end. You're cooking dinner. You're washing dishes. You're doing homework. Whatever. But you're at lunchtime eating and watching, but I want you to do at least one thing for me. Stop what you're doing and press that like button, please. Thank you so much. That's the only thing I need you to do. Okay? Anyway. Thank you so much. This has been Peyton 3.0, the EDM and drumstep vocalist Zombie Supreme. And I'll